Santa Cruz Seaplane replica of the Fairey IIID seaplane piloted by Sacadura Cabral and Gago Coutinho, which arrived in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil on June 17, 1922 during the first air crossing of the South Atlantic.
Nice plane.
Length 10 meters and 92, wingspan 14 meters and 5, height 3 meters and 70. By Carlos de Oliveira Correia, honoring the first South Atlantic air crossing by Sacadura Cabral, pilot, and Gago Coutinho, navigator. From March 30 to June 17, 1922, totaling 8,364 kilometers in 62 hours and 26 minutes of flight, with an average speed of 134 kilometers hour. Carlos de Oliveira is an agronomist and landscape architect with extensive experience in forest production and management. But art is his great passion, and for a decade he has been indulging in the execution of original work of art that mark the space and places. The most ambitious of his works, with the largest and most significant, came to São Brás de Alportel and recalls the memory of the great crossing that connected Portugal to Brazil in the first South Atlantic airlink. The installation Santa Cruz, a replica of the seaplane that reached Rio de Janeiro, piloted by Sacadura Cabral and Gago Coutinho. In this trip were used three Fairey IIID seaplanes belonging to naval aviation, the last of which, the Santa Cruz, is represented in this monument. The crossing linked Lisbon, Portugal, Las Palmas, Canary Islands, São Vicente and Santiago, Cape Verde, and the boulders of São Pedro and São Paulo, Fernando de Noronha, Recife, Bahia, Porto Seguro, Vitória and Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Sacadura Cabral was the only pilot throughout the trip. The two longest steps each lasted about 11 hours. Gago Coutinho devised the pioneering precision astronomical navigation method and its devices. A sextant with an artificial level and a course corrector. Special maps were prepared and pre-prepared astronomical calculations performed for specific points of each stage. It was this reliance on Gago Coutinho's astronomical methods that allowed them to find, in the middle of the sea, the Penedos, the São Pedro and São Paulo small cliffs with a length of 250 meters after a 1,652 km stage over the Atlantic without any outside help. None of the aircraft was equipped with a radio. The 1922 crossing linked four countries, three continents and two hemispheres, and coincided with the first centenary of Brazil's independence. UNESCO entered the report of the first South Atlantic air crossing into the memory of the world register on 27 July 2011, which is thereafter considered a World Heritage Site. The Great Voyage had begun on March 30, 1922, when Gago Coutinho and Sacadura Cabral left Lisbon aboard a modified single-engine Fairey IIID seaplane, which was named Lusitania. In the brave adventure, Sacadura Cabral was the pilot and Gago Coutinho the navigator, who created a completely new method of precision astronomical aeronautical navigation. He also developed an artificial horizon sextant model for measuring the height of the stars and invented the course corrector. These methods of astronomical navigation has forever revolutionized air navigation. Aboard the Lusitania, they performed in the Canary Islands and the Cape Verde archipelago, where they flew to the São Pedro and São Paulo cliffs in the South Atlantic. The rough sea caused damage to the aircraft during mooring. The trip was then resumed from Fernando de Noronha Island aboard the second seaplane sent by the Portuguese government. But a new fatality struck these brave airmen. An engine failure forced them to emergency rescue and left them shipwrecked for hours until rescued by an English freighter. Returned to Fernando de Noronha only on June 5th, they resumed their trip aboard a new Fairey IIID, transported from Portugal and baptized by the wife of the then president of Brazil, Epitácio Pessoa, as Santa Cruz. The seaplane then flew to Recife, making stops in Salvador da Bahia, Porto Seguro, Vitória, and reached Guanabara Bay in Rio de Janeiro on June 17, 1922, where they were greeted by huge manifestations of popular jubilation. In 1922, the first centenary of its independence was also celebrated in Brazil. This celebration was also one of the reasons that motivated this trip. We were in the early 1920s. In São Brás de Alportel, there were busy years. Cork activity was then one of the municipality's economic engines, although with the obvious signs of decline. Signals of concern were given by the constant complaints from manufacturers who were angry with the amounts of taxes and fees charged by the tax authorities. In May 1922, the city council announced the construction of a band for the music band, but still discussed its location, whether in Largo de São Sebastião or in the Torreiro next to the parish church. At this time, the gardens of Urbena were not even considered. In this hour of sublime grandeur for our fatherland, in this astral dream day ahead, behold, the soul of a pupil awakens at last from the deep lethargy in which it lay, and triumphantly taken to the luminous panoramas of infinity, from where everything is beautiful, where everything is pure, walks in a thrill of patriotic enthusiasm. The heroic deed, the extreme boldness of the two wise and illustrious Portuguese airmen Gago Coutinho and Sacadura Cabral, who are being crowned in this patriotic delirium of the cultured world with imperishable laurels of victory.